Sacred Heart of Jesus. Throughout the history, we see God sending great leaders to lead us out of many devastating crises. The turbulence and turmoil of the time only reveals the amazing potential puts in their soul and spirit. In Venerable Father Matthew Kadalikattil, the beloved founder of our congregation, we meet such a prophetic persona who continues to inspire the world with his exceptional charisma. On the occasion of the 86th death anniversary of our founder father, I wish all of you his spiritual blessings and guidance. I congratulate my loving sisters for preparing a small documentary to present our humble works of charity during this pandemic. May the Sacred Heart of Jesus bless us all. Thank you.
Father Matthew Kadalikattil was a saintly priest with whom God shared his dreams. Endowed with a heart of God's own nature, he lived on this earth as a symbol of his compassion and redeeming love. His heart throbbed with love of God. His hands remained raised before the Eucharistic Lord in intercession. His feet hastened towards the downtrodden to share the divine riches he received in prayer. We, his spiritual daughters who follow his footsteps, are assured of his paternal care in our strive to obtain redemption through love and service. In this time of great pandemic, the world looks up to us for credible hope and faith. As COVID-19 forces its way through towns and villages, instilling in people fear of death, fear of economic ruin, fear of the loss of dear ones, we are commissioned to act as prophets of compassion, mercy and hope. The heroic tradition handed down to us by our founder, Venerable Father Matthew Kadalikattil, and the founding members is the model for us to face the turmoil of our times too. A world devastated by the First World War, utter famine, fast spreading contagious diseases, incurable epidemics. In the midst of this chaos, there was seen a small community of sisters under the paternal care of Reverend Father Matthew, boldly facing the storm of excruciating calamities. Neither hunger nor death could deter their spirit. They were not disheartened even when five of their beloved members died in quick succession due to tuberculosis. Their unshakable trust in the divine providence emboldened them to pass through those adversities. Their services were not limited to their own people, but embraced with compassion the suffering brethren of the vicinity. COVID-19, the unprecedented pandemic, is unraveling its fury on the young and old, the rich and the poor alike. Following the example of the founder, we, his beloved daughters, are at toil night and day to bring healing to the sick and hope to the depressed. The zeal of the founder and the founding members stands as a beacon of light to give up safe zones and wade through the life-threatening waves of the pandemic.
Father, Venerable Father Matthew Kadalipatil was a great visionary and missionary. During his lifetime, he saw many people suffering socially, physically, psychologically and mentally, and they were not getting proper care. So, he visioned his own sisters working among the patients, and he sent two of them for nursing profession when nursing was not at all common and was not appreciated by the people. Continuing his mission, we try to alleviate the sufferings of the people, especially during this COVID-19 pandemic, when our presence and service are needed more than any other time. Many nurses are reluctant to work among the COVID patients. We are working with them and living with them 24 hours a day. Many of us have already contracted the disease. We are happy to fulfill the dream of our Founder Father.
Praise be to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. COVID-19, marked by anguish and fear, has affected a vast number of people, losing lives and economy. The entire society is going through an emotional and psychological depression due to coronavirus pandemic. It has challenged us almost in a cruel manner. Following the footsteps of our Founder Father, Venerable Father Matthew Kadalipatil, first priority of our sisters was to pray before the Eucharistic Lord in adoration, pleading for the entire world and sending vibrations of healing and well-being. As educators, classroom teaching has taken a quick reversal. Coping with the situation, we are successfully managing teaching learning process by conducting online classes, webinars, conferences, and conducting virtual PTMs and all the activities with much more personal touch than before. In today's technology-driven education, social distancing is not a hindrance for our sisters to meet and to greet each other. We are sure that once the storm is over and the monster is dead, we will reach the shore from the lockdown only to see the new world in order. May the Sacred Heart of Jesus be with us always and strengthen us on our apostolic journey.
The most significant context of today is the great pandemic, which brought pain, suffering, loss, and isolation to people all over the world. In this context, Jesus is calling us to find new ways to share our faith with a new apostolic enthusiasm. That is, bringing the good news of Jesus into every human heart. Our founder, Venerable Father Matthew Kathilikattil, urges us to be faithful to God's invitation to share our profound God experience with others. By the compassionate listening and the timely help we offer to the people around us enhances their inner vitality. Thus, we become souls of inspiration and hope to those facing crisis in our context. And thus, we respond in a manner which embodies our charism.
Praise be to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. In this great pandemic situation, where the infected and death rates of COVID patients increases day by day, the doctors of Sacred Heart in Delhi get into the lives of many moved by the words of the Lord, "I feel compassion on the crowd." By visiting the village around us and lending helping hands, irrespective of caste, creed and religion. Sisters, with much love and dedication and without any hesitation, go to the home quarantined COVID patients and those who are unable to go to hospitals and provide them medicines, food, vitamin C tablets, N95 masks, sanitizer, gloves, steam inhaler, etc. Also monitor their temperature and saturation level on regular basis. With the help of Diocesan Youth, we provide pulse oximeter to the needed families, motivate people to go for vaccination, and provide economic help for the RT-PCR test. Other than this, we give psychological support over the phone and through our physical presence too. A 24/7 help desk has created at the parish level to help the needy who can approach us at any time for any help. We are indeed blessed and guided by the constant intercession of our founder, Venerable Father Matthew Kathilikattil, to reach out with courage to these less privileged persons during this life-threatening disease, COVID-19.
Let us put our trust in the Sacred Heart of Jesus, who promised us, "I will be with you till the end of the ages," and repeat with our Founder Father, "I will lift up the cup of salvation and call on the name of the Lord."